Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to use Safari's reading list. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So if you ever see articles online and you don't have time to read them now, you can use Safari's reading list feature to temporarily save an article so you can go back to it and read it later. Alright, so say you find a page and you want to save it to your reading list. You can do so in several ways. One is to go up to the address bar, and if I move my cursor over it, you can see a little plus button there. I click that and it adds it to the reading list. You can see it floating off to the left. You could also go to bookmarks and add to reading list, or you can see the shortcut is Shift Command D. Now to view your reading list, you click on the Show Sidebar button here. The sidebar button has two modes, bookmarks or reading list. So click on reading list to see your reading list. You can also go to View and then Show or Hide Reading List Sidebar, Control Command 2 to bring it up right away. Now here you see all the items you saved to your reading list. To view one, you can just click it and it will bring it up here. Now once you view it, it's marked as red. So it will disappear from here, but not right away. It will stay there while you're still viewing the page. But it will automatically be removed the next time you return here, so it will eventually go away. For instance, if I were to close this Safari window here and open up a new window, you could see now it's missing from the reading list. But that doesn't mean it's gone. If I were to use my trackpad with two fingers or mouse with two fingers and scroll down, you could see there's some additional controls here. And one of those controls is whether or not everything in your reading list is listed or just unread articles. So the three unread ones are here, but if I go to all, I see everything including articles I've already read, including that article that we were just looking at. Now you can return this to the unread state in a variety of ways. One is to control click and you get some additional functionality here. For instance, I could mark this as unread. I could also, with two fingers on the trackpad, I could swipe from left to right and there's a mark as unread here. Swiping from right to left will actually give me the ability to instantly remove it so it doesn't go into unread or all, it's gone completely. I can also save offline. Saving offline is a really cool feature because it means it downloads the entire page and you can now access it when you're offline. So say if you're taking your MacBook on an airplane, you can now read that on the airplane even if you have no connection. There's even a feature in Safari Preferences under Advanced to save articles for offline reading automatically. So everything you then put in reading list will automatically have that turned on. So on your iPhone or iPad, you can add something to the reading list by clicking on the Actions button at the bottom. It's one with the box and the up arrow in it. And one of the options there is Add to Reading List. So you can add a page to the reading list. So the first time you do that, it's going to ask you if you want to have offline viewing turned on automatically. So we'll say sure. And now to view your reading list, you hit the bookmarks button at the bottom and there are three tabs at the top. And you can go between those to see bookmarks, reading list, and history. And reading list there shows you your reading list. You have a button at the bottom to show unread or show all to go between those. You can tap edit and then you can select some, and with those that are selected you can use the delete button at the bottom to get rid of them. You could also just swipe left to right to mark something as read or unread and right to left to delete it. And of course to view it you just tap and it will load up the page. So perhaps the best feature of Reading List is that it syncs using iCloud. So that means your reading list is the same on your Mac, on your iPhone, and on your iPad. You can add pages to it, you can remove pages, you can read pages, and everything remains synced across all of your devices. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.